morning, church family. I hope you're doing well. I hope you're ready to enjoy a beautiful 4th of July weekend. And we are certainly blessed in this nation. The Bible tells us in the book of Psalms 33, verse number 12, "Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord, and the people whom he hath chosen for his own inheritance." There's no doubt in my mind, as we think about our nation's birthday, July 4th, 1776, when the signers of the Declaration of Independence pinned their name to that document, there was no doubt they believed they were doing what God had given them to do. They believed they were following the will of God. And as I think about America, we can look around and see she has certainly been blessed. As you look back on this 4th of July, remind yourself of the foundation upon which this nation was built. When we quote the Pledge of Allegiance, one nation under God, I believe America is still a Christian nation. I believe she was founded upon Christian principles. And I think it's important that we as Christians find hope and find joy and peace in knowing that America was founded upon principles that bring honor and glory to God. I think as we look at the 4th of July, we also need to consider our freedom. I'm standing here in J.F. Gregory Park in front of the Veterans Memorial, and I'm reminded with so many flags and this time of the year of the freedom, not only the freedom that we enjoy, but the cost that was paid that we might enjoy it. We often say this, that while freedom is free, it costs something. And we have enjoyed the freedoms that God has given us as a nation, and we shouldn't take it for granted. We should remind ourselves often that patriotism is not passed down through the bloodstream. It must be handed down from one generation to the next. As you think about the freedoms that you enjoy and the foundation upon which this was built, this nation was built, remind yourself also of the faith that it took to follow the divine plan of God for America to be birthed. That faith is still required today. You know, if we get our eyes on the things that are going on around us, it won't be long before we'll become weak, we'll become discouraged or disappointed. But if we'll keep our eyes on the Lord through the eye of faith, looking unto Jesus, then we can rest in the hope that Jesus Christ can do far beyond anything we ever expect or think. As I think about the liberty and the freedom that we enjoy, the patriotism that we should pass down to the next generation, let me encourage you with this thought. That while patriotism is not passed down in the bloodstream, neither is Christianity. You and I need to understand that we need to hand the next generation behind us something that we've been given, something of great value, something that will cause them to find the same foundation that we have as Christians, the same freedom that we enjoy in Jesus Christ, and will teach them to follow by faith when we cannot see what is going on in the dark times in which we live. We must pass Christianity down to the next generation. And while I'm an American from the top of my head to the bottom of my foot, I want you to understand even greater than being an American is knowing Jesus Christ as my Savior and being a Christian. I hope and pray that as we think about the freedom that we enjoy in America, that we will understand the value of passing down the same blessing of knowing Jesus Christ to the generation that comes behind us. It doesn't happen naturally, but we must work at it. God's people need to understand that while we read in Psalm 33 here, "Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord," I want to say to you this morning that you're a blessed individual if God is the Lord of your life, if Jesus Christ is your personal Lord and Savior. And more than the freedom that we enjoy here in America, more than the blessing of being an American, the blessing of being a Christian, and the blessing of knowing Jesus Christ is the greatest freedom you can ever enjoy. I love you, church family. I love our nation. I want you to pray for her that God would send revival, that the Lord would stir our hearts, that God would help us as Christians to not only pass down the patriotism we've been given, but to pass down the Christianity that God is, the work that God has done in our life to the generation that comes behind us. May God help us to always strive to be one nation under God. And may we set the example as Christians in yielding to God's plan for our life. I love you. I hope you have a great day. Enjoy your 4th of July weekend. God bless you.